Hey nerds, what's up? Today we're gonna talk about whether the Wheel of Time is way too long. That wasn't even all the books. See you after the jump. Okay, so there's a rumor about the Wheel of Time, and I say rumor because I've never seen a primary source that substantiates it, but the rumor is that the Wheel of Time was originally planned to be a 6-book series, and that after the success of the first couple, Robert Jordan's publisher told him that he should keep it going and make the books as long as he wanted. Thus, we've ended up with a 14-book Wheel of Time series. The question I'm posing today is, was that right? Would Wheel of Time have been better if it was originally like it was supposed to be, which was a much shorter series? Or did we gain a lot by the longer books? I'm gonna present both sides and then tell you at the end which I think and believe in. So stick around to find out. Side one, the Wheel of Time is way too dang long. Look, I think there's a reason that the Wheel of Time has a pretty big drop-off rate in retention, particularly around midway of the series. I think a lot of it might have to do with Winter's Heart. Winter's Heart is a book that replays every single event of the previous book, just from different characters' perspectives. It's no wonder people get bored. Who wants to hear the same events over and over and over again in books that aren't not long? Okay, did you know that the Wheel of Time has over 4,410,000 words? It seems like with the story that there was to tell, you could shorten it a little bit. Additionally, because the book started as a 6-book series and then spread, I would guess probably after book 3, the pacing of the books is really off. You have the first 3 novels, which have this anxiety about them that the end of the world is coming, the end of the world is coming. And then all of a sudden, it's like 10 more books until the end of the world comes. You also have 3 books where the events are happening very quickly. Things are happening fast because we're trying to get to the end of this, you know, plot in 6 books. But then all of a sudden, it slowed down and just spread out. And I think that difference in pacing hurts the series a little bit and is why people have a hard time getting into the rest of the series. And I think it could have been better if the pacing was more consistent. Additionally, the same thing with that pacing and stretching the books is that the events of the books all happen in a very short time, but as readers, it's really difficult to imagine that because we're reading so much. The best way to explain this for me is Elaine's pregnancy. I remember when I was reading Wheel of Time, all I could think of is Elaine is still pregnant? 9 months haven't passed yet? And in fact, there was one part where she talks about she's not even far enough along to know something that she knows. And I'm like, you're not even 3 months yet? It's been like 5 books. How has it only been a few weeks? And I think that lack of time or that time distortion is something that really hurts the novels. I know it frustrated me to feel like we weren't getting anywhere time-wise. And I think that does come from the books being stretched so much. Additionally, Wheel of Time is known for being made fun of for some of its ridiculous descriptions. Descriptions of braid tugging and dress smoothing. And I think a bath scene with Elaine that lasts a lot of pages, and you wonder if maybe we cut down on the length of the books, we'd cut down on just a lot of unnecessary description. And maybe we cut out some unnecessary romances that I really hated. I will never get over Moraine and Tom. I will never forgive Jordan for that. Okay, so maybe it just wouldn't have been in there if we only had 6 books. Additionally, I've seen something that kind of disturbs me when I hear people talking about The Wheel of Time, and that's that Brandon Sanderson made the series so much better, or that his books are so much better. And now look, I love Brandon Sanderson. He's one of my favorite authors, but I hate this so much. All Sanderson did was realize the world Robert Jordan created. But the reason I think some people have this opinion is that Sanderson was writing the end of the novels. So he had so much stuff to cover, he had so much plot, and previously some of the books had been so slow plot-wise that he kind of gets this credit for like making it better. But really, it's just because the books are so long that things had been slowed down so much that by the time we get to the end, having event after event after event seems new and novel. And I personally don't think it was Sanderson at all. I think Jordan's last books would have been just as exciting and obviously maybe more true to characters because he wrote them. But I wonder if maybe Jordan had kept to his original plan, he would have gotten that credit for the plots that he wrote. Good books, like any art, are all about the editing. There's something to be said about a storyline that's just the length it needs to be. I kind of liken it between the difference between British and American TV. A lot of British TV series really stop when you're leave you wanting more. I always think of the British Office versus the American Office. I'm not dissing The American Office. I obviously love it, but it did just go on for so long beyond what it should have. If it had just ended, maybe it would have been better in all of our minds as the legacy of it. And so maybe Wheel of Time suffers from that a little bit. That if it had just been the length it was intended to be, it would have been a stronger novel. So let's recap. Side one, Wheel of Time is too long. We could cut out an entire repetitive novel. We could have less descriptions, less romances that seemed a little pointless, more concise, better time perception, and more plot points to cover in a single book. Let's check out the other side of the issue. Side two, the Wheel of Time is perfect as it is. Honestly, I think maybe Wheel of Time's length is one of the reasons it is so famous. I'm a big fan. I've actually worn a great serpent ring ever since I read the series. I wear it every day. And something I notice with fans is that we love to lovingly trash on some of the sillier and longer aspects of the Wheel of Time that probably aren't needed. And I think it actually brings the fandom together to recognize the Wheel of Time as this great work of art that also maybe has some silly things in it. And I don't think that would happen if it was a lot shorter. Additionally, the world building in Wheel of Time is famous for a reason, and I think that world building wouldn't have been as famous if Jordan wasn't allowed the time he took to build all of the facets. And actually, something I think Jordan is extremely good at, and I haven't seen actually in a lot of other fantasy novels, is his ability to talk about moral ambiguity. He does such an excellent job of creating factions and giving those factions reputations, and then turning those reputations on their head. So you may have an organization that has one reputation, but then you meet people from that organization and they're not what they said, but then some individuals within them are good. And it's this moral ambiguity of how we view entities in real life versus the individuals who make them up. The best examples of this obviously are the White Cloaks and the Aes Sedai. They both have very big reputations, but when we meet them, it's a little jarring because our expectations of those groups aren't really what they live up to be. And that is just like such a genius move. And I think there was no way we could have explored that if the Wheel of Time was shorter. And I think the Wheel of Time would be less great if we didn't get to explore that. Additionally, we get a lot of character payoffs for minor characters. And some of those minor characters have some of my favorite stories, and I just don't think there would have been time to explore them in shorter books. What I immediately think of is the Brown Aes Sedai Varen and her ending. I loved her ending so much. It was so unexpected, and it added so much to the story. But there's no way a small character like that would have had time to be developed in a 6-book series. Additionally, Galad and Berelaine, at the end when her Aes Sedai does what she does to save Galad, it's such a touching moment, and I don't think it could have been without our knowledge of all those characters, and they're such minor characters in the grand scheme of things, that it just wouldn't have had time, and I think we would have really missed that. Additionally, it allows for way more character growth of the main characters. I think of Matt. Matt's so annoying for the first couple of books, and then he just grows to be this awesome character, and I really love Matt. But when I think of his story in a 6-book arc, I have a hard time thinking I'd have the time with him to change my opinion on him. And additionally, the three primary characters in the first couple novels are really the trio of boys, Rand, Perrin, and Matt. And I think that if the books had been shorter, we wouldn't have gotten to explore the female character backgrounds as much. And as the Wheel of Time stands as it is, like, the female characters get so much attention and they get their own character stories, and that's so wonderful, and I just don't think it would have happened in the same way. I especially think of Egwene, whose story I love. She gets practically a whole novel about her journey as an Aes Sedai, and that probably would have been reduced to a couple chapters, and so the emotional weight of those things wouldn't be as strong. And emotional weight is something that definitely happens in the longer series, because one thing we get is, because there are so many different perspectives, there are 2,600 named characters, I think, a little over that. Because we get so many different perspectives, there are so many times in the novel where you're like, no, don't do that. You don't know that someone else is doing this. Oh no. And the anxiety is so much up because as readers, we actually get to know what's happening in the whole world. And it's very unique in that way. There's not a lot of surprises. I mean, there are surprises for the reader, but we know what all the factions are doing and moving. And so it creates this anxiety and it creates this joy when things happen and this desperation when things happen that I don't think would have been as successful in a shorter series. Okay, so let's sum up this side. We have a fully realized fantasy world with good world building. We have tons of character arcs. We have huge character payoffs, even for minor characters. We get to explore moral ambiguity, and we have a bigger emotional weight because we really understand everything that's happening in the world. So, which side am I on? I'm gonna cheat a little bit. I think The Wheel of Time would have been perfect as maybe an 11 book series. I think there's definitely a couple books of content we could cut out that might have made it a little stronger. But if I had to choose between a 6-book Wheel of Time or the original or the one we have, the 14-book Wheel of Time, I would for sure choose the 14-book Wheel of Time. It's hard to imagine Wheel of Time as anything other than what it is, and I just love it. So let me know, are you a Wheel of Time fan? I'd like to hear your opinion on this and what you think. And if you liked this video, please like and subscribe and comment below your thoughts. And if you'd like to know what I'm reading, you can follow me on Instagram at bookborn.reviews. Hope to see you next time. Bye.